There is that one thing. AC system. Why the hell did it unlock now?
sight wide open. He was so ugly, like, wow, I got a good look at him, and Christ, he does not look like he used to. The hiss must have messed him up or something. He looks like a bar rag that's been twisted by the world's strongest man, or a monster from some 80s horror movie, you know, back when it was all practical effects. Ugh, nasty.
Real.
Did you say something? Remember, I can't hear you. Never mind, just go after Hartman. Ah, so disgusting.
I've written, rewritten. The darkness wants to hide the past and make me lose my way. I trust what I read on these pages. I wrote them for a reason. Cut through the reality, tear it apart, and rewrite it. They are drawn to the mystery.
How convenient that I would have a lamp just where I need it. Fuck you know.
Thank you for meeting with us again, Dr. Hartman.
It's my pleasure, gentlemen. I hope the information I've provided thus far has been of some small use.
It's been invaluable, Doctor. Really, we have a much clearer picture of this event, thanks to your accounts.
Well, I do consider myself a keen observer.
We did have one question, though. You mentioned in an earlier conversation that your patients displayed, and I'm paraphrasing here, unnatural abilities that you in fact encouraged during the time in your lodge. It'd be very helpful if you could fill us in on the details there.
Of course. Like yourselves, I work to understand and even bend the rules of our earthly paradigm. My patient's well-being was paramount, of course, but I would hardly be a man of science if I did not reach out at the underlying. As I stated in my written proposal, I believe working alongside your organization could be greatly beneficial to both parties. Sharing notes, as they say.
Thank you, Doctor. That's all we need to hear. Remy?
Dr. Emil Hartman, you have been found in breach of codes 4, 8, and 74 of the Federal Bureau of Control criminal offenses.
What? You can't do this? I am a well-connected man. You're making a dire mistake, my friend.
You'll be detained until further notice and all personal property will be confiscated, including the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
That's preposterous. You can't just seize my property. I'm a United States citizen. I have rights. That lodge is my life's work. I'm offering you years of research.
Get him out of here.
You're making a mistake. You have to listen to me. You have to listen.
Again, I had a plan. I know it. I've forgotten.
Whatever is going on with Wake, he clearly needs some help.
Escape, right? His escape. Wake needed a hero. A hero needed a crisis. For the part in the story about the government agency, Wake needed something special, something to convey an alien force mimicking human intelligence.
Another replica. Like the one they made for Orton.
Send a ranger to my location.
Make way for the director!
These are the notes of Dr. Emil Hart.
No, he's pumping up.
Hartman won't be a problem anymore, Langston. But investigations need someone to run it. Interested?
I've seen what happens to sector heads, ma'am. No, thank you. Ma'am, I'm getting something on my terminal here, an AWE alert from Bright Falls, Washington. But it might be a glitch. The date's all wrong, a couple of years in the future. And we're in lockdown, there shouldn't be any incoming signals.
Maybe it was active before we went into lockdown? Are there agents on site?
Let me check. Agent Estevez is the field agent in charge of monitoring the site, so she should be there to let us know if the situation has been through any major changes recently. This must be where they studied Hartman. Kinda looks like Dylan's cell. I wonder if they treated him as badly.
These are the notes of Dr. Emil Hartman. I am continuing my work alone again, since certain parties were too blind to recognize a golden opportunity. Despite my generous offers, the conversations came to naught. Some people simply do not value collaboration as I do. Though I believe now that it was for the best. The sort of bold pioneering work that I am undertaking cannot thrive under the shackles of bureaucracy and regulation. I have a history of seeking such partnerships. There was a time when I had hoped Alan Wake and I could collaborate. Together we could have produced art such that the world has never seen. Wake was stubborn, egotistical. Writers usually are. Disappointing nonetheless. But now, like Tom before him, Wake has disappeared into Cauldron Lake. And this is where my work turns hypothetical. Since he was lost to the lake, Thomas Zane has been observed by various townspeople. This indicates to me that the individuals within the lake are not entirely gone. I anticipate Wake will similarly return one day. While I may harbor some resentment for the man, his raw talent and determination are undeniable. From this, I have concluded that the lake and the dark place within it are not as removed from this world as I previously thought. Given my acute awareness of what awaits within, my meticulous preparations, and my considerable education, I believe myself much more prepared than either Tom or Wake. I should be able to cross into that dark realm with the chance to return as they have. All that remains is the dive itself. It frightens me, I admit, but such is the burden of the truth seeker. I will take my plunge into the dark tomorrow with only the light of knowledge to guide me. It is time for a breakthrough. Until I return.
Well, that didn't go as planned. Really?
Ranger sent to this location, stat.
Don't give an inch!
Oh, fuck off.
I knew it! The moon landing was fake. Area 51 is a cover-up. Aliens are real!
Although, none of that sounds as exciting as it did a week ago.
I knew it! I need a goddamn lamp, for fuck's sake. Well, Control proved it. Moon landing was fake. Close that. What the hell? I don't fucking believe it. Not fine.
This is the director. I need a ranger at this location immediately.
Goddamn light. Fuck off.
There you go. Doesn't that feel better?
Oh shit. There is no fucking light. I know I had the light here somewhere. Oh, for fuck's sake. Fucking waste of time.